Hi and welcome to a new tutorial, this new blanket, Candy Floss Daydreams. This is a design of Catherine Bly. Catherine gave me permission to explain this beautiful blanket to you on my channel. If you want to visit the website of Catherine Bly, then click the link below this video. There you find the written pattern and all the colors yarn that Catherine working with. I use Color Crafter from Scapius. It's a 100% premium acrylic yarn, 100 gram and 300 meters yarn on one ball. The five colors that I used, color 1068 Den Helder, color 1080 Venlo, color 1240 Ommen, color 1218 Zandvoort and color 1064 Veenendaal. You'll find under this video and on my website biancascrochetpalace.com how many balls you need in total. I'm working with a 4mm crochet hook. Let's get started! We make square number 6 and we need to make 20 of these. We start with a magic circle. We make a chain 1 and then in the magic circle we work 4 single crochets. Enter your hook in the circle, grab your yarn, yarn over and pull through 2. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4, and pull on the beginning yarn and tight to close the circle. And now we work a slip stitch into the first single crochet to close the first round. Yarn over, pull through, and pull through. With the same color, we make a chain 1. That's only to high up that stitch. In the same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round, you work 2 single crochets. That's 1. Back in the same stitch for a second. Into the next stitch, 2 single crochets. It's 1 and 2. That's the repeat of this round. In the next stitch, 2 single crochets. And in the next stitch, 2 single crochets. And we make a slip stitch in the beginning, single crochet on the top, yarn over, pull through and pull through. Round 3 with the same color and we start with a beginning 3 double crochet cluster in the first stitch. We begin with a chain 3 and now we yarn over and the hook in the same stitch where we make the slip stitch in the previous round. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 2. We yarn over, go back in that same stitch, grab your yarn and pull up, yarn over and pull through 2. Now we have 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops. We make a chain 2, 1 and 2 and then a 3 double crochet cluster in the next stitch. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull through 2, that's 1, yarn over into the same stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, that's 2. Yarn over, back in the same stitch, Yarn over, pulled for 2. Now you have 4 loops on the hook, 3 of the not complete double crochets, and the chain stitch. Yarn over and pull through 4 loops. And then we make and chain 2. And this is the repeat we make all the way around, 8 clusters in total. Into the next stitch, 3 double crochets together, that's 1, 2, and 3, yarn over and work together, and then chain 2. Into the next stitch, a cluster of 3 double crochets together, that's 1, 2, 3, and work together, and then chain 2 all the way around till we have 8 clusters in total. And then chain 2 in the next stitch, a cluster of 3 double crochets together. Chain 2 and a cluster in the next stitch. And chain 2. And the last cluster of this round. And then we have to make a chain 2. Now we have 8 clusters of 3 double crochets together with between a chain 2. In the beginning we work an invisible join. We cut the yarn and open up the stitch. And then with a needle we make that invisible join in the beginning, not in the first stitch, but in the second. The first stitch is the beginning cluster here on the top, that's your first stitch. We skip that stitch, we go to the next stitch, and that's the first chain stitch. Under through that V, pull through, now you go back to the last chain, only in the back loop, and then pull through. On the back, I make a little knot to secure my thread. Through that loop and pull, and then I wave in the back of the stitches, also the beginning yarn of the magic circle, make a little knot on the through that loop here, and then pull. And then you wave in that little tail. Round 4, and I make a slip knot on the hook with a nil color. And we begin with a standing single crochet in an any chain 2 space between the clusters. Yarn over and pull through 2. Now in that same space we work 2 single crochets. That's 1, into the same space, 2, 3 single crochets in that same space. Now we work a front post half double crochet around the cluster, yarn over, go around the cluster, from the front to the back, from the back to the front, around that stitch, Grab your yarn, then pull through. 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 3 loops from front post half double crochet around the cluster. Then in the next space we work 3 single crochets in that same space. And we work a front post half double crochet around the next cluster. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through 3. That's the repeat we work all the way around. In the next space, 3 single crochets. And a front post half double crochet around the next cluster. Into the next space, 3 single crochets. And a front post half double crochet around the next cluster. Work so all the way around. And the last cluster, around that cluster, and front post half double crochet. And now we work a slip stitch into the first stitch here on the top. That's your first standing single crochet. Under through that V-stitch, grab your yarn, pull through, and pull through. Round 5 with the same color and we make a slip stitch into the next stitch. Under through that V-stitch, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through for a slip stitch. We begin with a chain 4. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 counts of a double crochet and a chain 1. Now we work a double crochet in that same stitch. We skip the next stitch and then we work a double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet in the next stitch. We skip and then in the next stitch a double crochet, a chain 1 and a double crochet. That's the repeat we work all the way around. We skip the next stitch. And in the next stitch, a double crochet, a chain 1, and a double crochet in that same stitch, all the way around. We skip the next stitch, and in the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, and a double crochet in that same stitch. Skip 1, and a double crochet. Chain, double crochet in the next stitch. My last stitches, double crochet, a chain, and a double crochet in the same stitch. And now we work an invisible join in the beginning double crochet. We cut the yarn and open up the stitch. And we skip that first stitch, and that's the chain 3, counts for a double crochet. In the next stitch, that's your fourth chain stitch, there we make the invisible join. Go back to the last double crochet, only in the back loop. Now on the back, I make a little knot to secure my thread. And weave both tails in. Round 6 with a new color. In this round we will only working into a chain 1 space. And we start with a beginning standing double crochet in the first chain 1 space of round 5. And that's between 2 clusters. Yarn over, enter your hook in that space, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2 for a standing double crochet. It's between the 2 clusters in that space. In that same space you work 2 double crochets, that's 1 and 2. Now we work in chain 2, 1, 2 and 3 double crochets in that same space. 1, 2 and 3. Now we skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and into the next chain 1 space that's between the 2 double crochets we work a single crochet. We skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and then we work into the next chain 1 space. Make a chain 1, and we skip the next 2 stitches, and then in the next space we work a cluster of 3 double crochets together. That's 1, 2, and 3 double crochet, and work together. And then we make a chain 1. Go back in that same stitch with another cluster of 3 double crochets. That's 1, 2 and 3, and work together, and then a chain 1, and go back for a third time with another 3 double crochet cluster into the same space. And now a chain 1. Skip the next 2 stitches and then work a single crochet in the next chain 1 space. And this is the way how we work all the way around. We skip the next 2 stitches and in the next chain 1 space we work 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets in that same space. That's 1, 2 and 3 double crochets, make a chain 2 and 3 double crochets in that same space. 1, 2, and 3. You skip the next 2 stitches, and in the next chain 1 space, you work a single crochet. Into the next chain 1 space, we are working clusters. Make a chain 1, and into the next chain 1 space, we work a 3 double crochet cluster. That's 1, 2, and 3, and work together, and a chain. Into the same space, 3 double crochet cluster. And a chain, and a 3 double crochet together cluster. Into the same space, and then a chain 1. You skip the next 2 stitches, and then into the next stitch, you work a single crochet. Work so all the way around. And in the beginning, we work an invisible join to close this round. This is my last space. We work a single crochet in that space. And now we cut the yarn, open up that stitch, pull the hook all the way up, and then we make with the needle that invisible join in the beginning. Not in that first stitch. That's the first standing double crochet. We skip that stitch. We go to the next. And then to the last stitch. That's the single crochet. Only in the back loop. Make a little knot on the back. And weave both tails in. Round 7 with a new color on the hook. And we begin with a standing single crochet in any chain 2 space. And that's here between the 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets. In that space, we start with a standing single crochet. In that same space, 2 single crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. Now we start on the repeat of this round. We make a single crochet into the next 2 stitches. It's 1 and 2, and now we work a front post treble crochet together, 2 together across the second double crochet of double crochet. Chain 1, a double crochet of round 5. And that's this stitch here. And in that stitch here. Around these 2 stitches, we work a front post treble crochet 2 together. For a treble crochet, we yarn over twice. Then go around that first double crochet here under, around that stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. Now we stop. We go to the next double crochet, we yarn twice over. Go around that stitch. Here's your V stitch, and then that stitch next to it. Go around that stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. Now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull for 3. Now we have work 2 double treble crochets together. Skip the next 3 stitches of round 6 and then we work a single crochet on the top of that first cluster. Then we work 2 single crochets in the chain 1 space. That's 1. Go back in the same space, 2. And a single crochet on the top of the next cluster. 2 single crochets in the next chain 1 space. That's 1 and 2 and 1 single crochet into the third cluster. We make now a front post treble crochet 2 together across the second double crochet of the double crochet chain 1 and the double crochet, and that's this stitch here and also in this stitch here. These 2 stitches, there we make that 2 front post treble crochet together, yarn twice over, go around that first treble crochet, yarn over twice, go to the next double crochet, that's your V stitch, and that double crochet here, we make that second treble crochet. And we work both stitches together. We skip the next 3 stitches of round 6. That's 1, 2 and 3. And then into the next 2 stitches we work a single crochet. That's 1 and into the next stitch 2. And then into the next chain 2 space we work 3 single crochets. That's 1, 2 and 3. And we start with the next repeat into the next 2 stitches 1 single crochet. Now we're working a front post treble 2 together across the second double crochet of the first double crochet chain 1 double crochet from round 5 and in the first double crochet of the next double crochet chain 1 and double crochet of round 5. Twice over. Around the next double crochet, this stitch here, yarn over and pull through 3. Now we skip the next 3 stitches of round 6 and we work a single crochet in the first cluster, then into the chain 1 space 2 single crochets and a single crochet on the top of the next cluster. Into the next chain 1 space 2 single crochets and a single crochet in the next cluster. And then we work a front post treble crochet 2 together across the next 2 double crochets. That's the first double crochet here. Yarn twice over and around this double crochet here. And work 2 together. Skip the next 3 stitches of round 6 and then we work a single crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1 and 2 and 3 single crochets in that next chain 2 space. And then we start all over. Work so all the way around and then in the beginning we make an invisible join. These are my last stitches, the last 2 single crochets. And we cut the yarn to make that invisible join in the beginning. Not in that first stitch, that first standing single crochet, we go to the next stitch, go back to the last stitch, only in the back loop. Round 8 with a new color on the hook and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of any 3 single crochets group. And that's on the point here. Here we make that 3 single crochets, and then in the second you start with a standing single crochet. Into that same stitch we make 2 single crochets in that stitch. That's 1, back in the same stitch, 2. You start on the repeat of this round. Single crochet into the next stitch, and then we skip the next 2 stitches. Then we're going to work in the next stitch, and that must be on the top of that 2 treble crochet together. We work in that stitch 5 double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Skip the next 2 stitches, and then we work a single crochet into the next 3 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, into the next stitch, and 3. And then we skip the next 2 stitches and work 5 double crochets into the next stitch, and that must be on the top of the 2 treble crochet together. That's 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and work a single crochet into the next stitch. And then 3 single crochets into the next stitch. That's 1, 2, and 3. And that's the repeat of this round. We start all over again. Into the next stitch, 1 single crochet. Then we skip the next 2 stitches and work 5 double crochets into the next stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we skip the next 2 stitches and work a single crochet into the next 3 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and in the next stitch, 3. Skip 2 stitches and work 5 double crochets in the next stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we skip the next 2 stitches and make a single crochet into the next stitch. Into the next stitch, 3 single crochets in that same stitch. And that's repeat 2 complete. And we start all over again. Into the next stitch, 1 single crochet. Skip the next 2 stitches and make 5 double crochets into the next stitch. Skip 2 stitches and make a single crochet into the next 3 stitches. Then we skip 2 stitches and make 5 double crochets into the next stitch. Skip 2 stitches and work a single crochet into the next stitch and 3 single crochets in the next. That's 1, 2, and 3 in the same stitch. And then 1 single crochet into the next. Work so all the way around all your stitches. one stitch to go, my last single crochet. We cut the yarn to make an invisible join in the beginning. Round 9 with a new color, and we begin with a standing double crochet in the second single crochet of an any 3 single crochet group. And that's on the point here in the second single crochet. That's the point where we start with a standing double crochet. Into that same stitch, we work 2 double crochets. That's 1 and 2. Then we make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and back in that same stitch with 3 double crochets. That's 1, 2, and 3. Now we start on the repeat of this round. We skip the next 2 stitches and then we make a back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. That's that shell here, yarn over, go around that first double crochet, and then on the back you grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through all the 3 loops. One back post half double crochet around the next stitch, and back post half double crochet also around the next stitch, that's 3, 5 in total, go to the next stitch, 4, and the last one, number 5. We make a single crochet into the next stitch. That's our first single crochet here of that group of 3. Then we make a chain 1 and we skip the next stitch. That's the second single crochet, and then in the next single crochet we work a single crochet. Around the next 5 double crochets, we work a back post half double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We skip the next 2 stitches and then we work a 3 double crochet, chain 2 and 3 double crochet into the next stitch. And that's the center stitch here, the second stitch. There we make that 3 double crochet. And chain 2 and 3 double crochets in that same stitch. And this is the same corner than the first corner. We repeat all these stitches 3 more times all the way around, and I'll show you once more. We skip the next 2 stitches and then we work a back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. And then we make a single crochet into the next stitch, make a chain 1, skip the next stitch, and then in the next stitch a single crochet. And back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. Skip the next 2 stitches and work 3 double crochets, chain 2 and 3 double crochets into the next stitch. Repeat all these stitches 2 more times, and then here on the top of that first standing double crochet we make a slip stitch. I'm all the way around, I make a slip stitch here in the beginning on the top of that first standing double crochet. Round 10 with the same color, and we begin with a chain 1 and then back in that same stitch with a single crochet. Also into the next 2 stitches 1 single crochet. That's 1, into the next stitch 2. Now we work in that chain 2 space 3 single crochets, 1, 2 and 3. For a new corner, and then a single crochet into the next 9 stitches, and your first stitch is here, that first double crochet after that chain 2 space, 1, into the next stitch, 2, in the next, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then we work in single crochet into the next chain 1 space, that's here. In that space we work also a single crochet, and now into the next 9 stitches 1 single crochet, that's 1, into the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we're in that chain 2 space, 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all these stitches all the way around, and we make an invisible join here in the beginning. My last stitches, I make a single crochet in that chain 1 space. And then we have to make 9 single crochets to close this round. But in the beginning we work for the corner 3 single crochets. That means that we have to make only 6 single crochets here on the end. That makes 9 single crochets in total. Cut the yarn and make an invisible join here in the beginning. Not in the first stitch, but in the second stitch. Round 11 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of an any corner 3 single crochet group, and that's here. And then in the second stitch there we start with a standing single crochet, then we make two single crochets in that same stitch. For a new corner, into the next 9 stitches, one single crochet, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we work a 3 double crochet cluster in the skipped stitch from round 8, and that's this stitch here. In that stitch we work a 3 double crochet cluster. Yarn over, go with your hook into that stitch and fold your work to the back to create more space. Grab your yarn and pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, and work 2 doubles in that same stitch and work that cluster together and chain 1. Into that same space 3 double crochet cluster, that's 1, 2 and 3, work together and make a chain 1. Into that same space and 3 double crochet cluster. Now we skip the next 4 stitches of round 10 on the back. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, and then into the next stitch we work a single crochet. And we work also a single crochet into the next 7 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Into the next stitch, and that's the second stitch of the 3 single crochets in the corner. We make a new corner of 3 single crochets. It's 1, 2 and 3. And this is the same corner than the first corner. We work on the right side of the clusters here, 9 single crochets. And on the left side of the clusters, 8 single crochets. Work all these stitches 3 more times all the way around, and we make a slip stitch here in the beginning. I'm all the way around, I make my last 3 clusters. Now we skip on the back 4 stitches, and then in the last 8 stitches 1 single crochet. This is my last stitch, and now we work on the first standing single crochet and slip stitch. Round 12, and we start with a chain, and then in the same stitch we work a single crochet. 3 single crochets in the next stitch, and that's the center point of the corner, that's 1, 2 and 3. And now we work in the next 10 stitches 1 single crochet, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, on the back of the clusters, we skipped 4 stitches. In these 4 stitches, we work a half double crochet. Yarn over. Go to the first stitch, of that skipped stitches, see ya? Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 3. That's the first of 4. That's 2. Into the next stitch. 3. And into the next stitch. 4. That's on the back of the clusters. Now you work in the next 9 stitches, 1 single crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then the next stitch is the corner stitch. We make a new corner of 3 single crochets in that same stitch. 1, 2, and 3 for a new corner. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all these stitches all the way around. And then we make in the beginning an invisible join to close this round. At the end of this round, we make 9 single crochets, but in the beginning we work also 1 single crochet. That means we have to make 8 single crochets here on the end, with the first single crochet that we work for the corner, that's then 9 single crochets in total. Cut the yarn and make an invisible join in the beginning. Round 13 with a new color on the hook, and this is the final round, and then we're done with this square. We begin with a standing single crochet, and in any corner 3 single crochets, and then in the second stitch there we begin with a standing single crochet. Into that same stitch we work also 2 single crochets to complete this first corner. That's 1 and 2. Now we work a single crochet in the next 10 stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we work around the first cluster and front post half double crochet of round 11. Yarn over, go around that first cluster. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 3. Skip the next stitch of round 12, that's here on the back, and then we work a single crochet into the next stitch of round 12. Around the next cluster, a front post half double crochet. Then we skip the next stitch of round 12 on the back and work a single crochet into the next stitch of round 12. Then around the next cluster, also a front post half double crochet. Now we skip on the back 1 stitch and work a single crochet into the next stitch. Now we make into the next 9 stitches 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we work into the corner stitch a new corner of 3 single crochets in that same stitch. It's 1, 2, and 3. This is the same corner than the first corner, and we repeat all these stitches after the first corner 3 more times all the way around, and then we make here in the begin our last invisible join. And we're done. Now you have to make 20 of these squares in total. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and please thumbs up under my videos. Click on the bell so you don't miss any of my new upload tutorials. You can find me also on Facebook and Instagram and my website biancascrochetpalace.com. Here's a suggestion for another video. I hope you like it. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye!